Your ass been called somebody. Oh, hell yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, WWE proudly brings to you one of the biggest douchebags in the world, the liar, Road Dogg, Jesse James. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that was a little bit of a satire there. But me and Road Dogg, Jesse James, the Road Dogg, Jesse James, whatever the fuck you want to call this douchebag, you know, I used to like him. I still like him as a wrestler. I mean, he was just a jerk to me, though, I thought. Especially as an employee representing WWE. I mean, he's a WWE producer. I thought it was pretty disrespectful to me just voicing my opinion. He just basically called me negative, ignored my opinion, you know, made fun of me. I don't like that. You know, I'm just... You know, most times when you express your opinion to a company and you are disappointed in their product, they will reach out to you and say what's wrong. Or they will even, a lot of times, offer you a free product. But no, in this case, I get made fun of, you know? Not that I'm upset or anything. I mean, I don't expect anything less from the scumbags at WWE. But, you know, this is how WWE works, you know? Your fans are upset. They just say, fuck you, pretty much. Literally, almost. They say, fuck you. So, yeah, I mean, again, you know, if you have a problem with a company, I mean... When there's a job, you know, like I work at batting cages, and when something goes wrong, or so somebody fucks up, we don't go, yeah, fuck you, you know, or they complain, we don't go, fuck you, we actually pay attention to the issues going on, and we actually address the customer in a polite and respectful way. But instead, you know, I'm just expressing my opinion, you know, the product sucks, I don't like it. And he says, oh, you little negative person, fuck you. So let's go through this here. Brian G. James, a.k.a. Road Dogg, tweets out, the WWE Usos entrance never gets old, and neither does WWE Sheamus kicking someone in the face. Oh my god, he must be kidding. I mean, was this guy from the Attitude Era? I mean, just a total fucking... He's gotta be lying. I mean, he works for the product. He works for the company. So, he cannot seriously say that. Oh my god. It never gets old. Come on, Road Dogg. Who are we kidding? This has been old for months now. And he says, hashtag SmackDown. And you know he's being a company guy when he puts an exclamation point on the end of his sentence and does a hashtag SmackDown, because I never put exclamation points at the end of my at the end of my tweets. I don't bother doing that random ass bullshit. I rarely do a hashtag. The only time I'll do a hashtag is if I'm talking about Raw, and I'll tweet out "This is boring" and I'll put hashtag Raw so you know I'm talking about Raw. But I don't fucking know. Maybe he did that on his own, but I doubt it. Oh, Andy used at WWE Sheamus. I don't know. That's a small issue or whatever. And then I say, reply to him, yes it does, it is the same shit every week, because he said it never gets old. So I'm saying, yeah, it does, it's the same shit every week. I mean, it gets old, you know. They don't play the same episode of a TV series on, you know, every fucking, they don't have the same fucking, like in The Walking Dead, they won't have the same fight scene every fucking week, you know. They won't have the same fucking scenes every week. They'll vary up the scenes. They'll have different scenes. So I basically am complaining, just stating my true opinion. I'm not a liar, I'm not a troll, I'm just stating my opinion. I say, yes it does, it is the same shit every week. And then he tweets back, aw, how cute, another negative internet wrestling fan. It is so rare to see one of you, I wish I had my camera. So basically just disrespecting my opinion, making fun of me. And I wouldn't have that big a problem with it if he wasn't employed with WWE, but he's a WWE producer. So in turn, he's representing the company. And so this just tells me that WWE doesn't give a shit about their fans that are upset. And he's like, it's so rare. I mean, he must be fucking blind. He must be just fucking in La La Land. I don't know what fucking planet he's on. La La Land on fucking Pluto. He's beyond Pluto. He's in another fucking galaxy, solar system, whatever the fuck. He's fucking, you know, you can't even fucking get, you know, you get the telescope out, you can't even fucking see where he is with the fucking telescope. I mean, the Hubble Bubble, you can't even see where he is. He's so far, just a lot of people. I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. A lot of people. This is rare to see somebody complain about the product. Are you kidding me? Fucking people are complaining all over the place. I like videos that say, raw review, fuck WWE, raw review, 0 out of 10 stars. And they get like 13 likes and 0 dislikes. They get like maybe 90% like to dislike ratio, with 90% of them being likes usually. So I mean, I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. So then I replied back, many people have the same mindset as me. There is no variety in the product, just the same things every week. The Usos and especially Sheamus are becoming way more unpopular with the fans. I'm just speaking my opinion and many others agree with me. So I'm basically saying, yeah, I mean, many others agree with me. Because, I mean, I can tell. I mean, I get some people out there, oh, you know, it's being negative. But most people I see agree with me. There's not many people that disagree with me. A lot of people think the product is shit. All right, Triple or Road Dog. And then I say, oh, I also said Sheamus and Usos are becoming way more unpopular. That's true. I mean, you don't see big pops for the Usos or Sheamus. You don't see any, you know, you don't see people getting all worked up about Sheamus or the Usos. I mean, maybe some 9-year-old kids and some, you know, adults that have like 9-year-olds in the stands. But I don't see that many people getting worked up about Sheamus or the Usos. Because why? Because they're the same shit every week and they're boring. At first, I mean, the Usos were, you know, a lot of people liked them. But that's when I was ranting on them. I always ranted on them and a lot of people liked them. But now, flash forward a year later, 6 months later, 3 months later, whatever, people are beginning to not like them. They're gaining the same mindset as me, I think. They might not hate him like I do, but they don't like him. I don't think. That's what I'm seeing, at least. Then I say, your ratings are going down and the company is losing money. Why? Because the product is sucking. And then he basically says I'm wrong. He says the company is not losing money, even though in the second quarter, I read a Huffington Post article, the company lost like $15.4 million. And the stock went down like 200%. The company's not losing money. No, I mean, it's not. Again, I mean, it's just like fucking, you know, saying that wall's not blue back there. That wall is red. And Road Dog, I'm Road Dog. No, Ruthless Rainer, I'm pretty sure that wall's red. That wall's red. No, Road Dog, that wall, I believe it's blue. I think it's blue. No, I believe it's not. It's like that. I mean, it's... Then they say the ratings are going down, which they are. I mean, ever since 06, I looked at the chart, they're going fucking down. At the Attitude Era, they were like 5, 6s. They were between like 5 and 7 during their prime, and now they're down to like fucking 2.8. Yeah, they're not going down. Yeah, they're not going down, you know? They're not going down. You know, it's like fucking first grade math. What's greater? It's 2 or 6. What's greater, 2.8 or 6.0 or 5.0? 5.0? Do you need to go back to fucking preschool, Road Dog? Huh? To realize that the ratings are dropping and the company is losing money? Open your eyes. Jeez. I mean, if you compare it back to fucking, you know, like over the long run, I guess you could say they're making money. But this is, you know, because I think like in the past few years, they've actually made a decent amount of money. They just lost a ton of money. That's why the company is losing money. They just lost money. You know, maybe back in 08, 09, 2010, I actually looked at the revenue over the past 5 years for the company. And the most money they made, I was looking at it on a website. Now, I don't know if this is a credible source or not, but they made way more money in 08 and 09 than they did in the next 3 years. So to say this company is, you know, getting more money, I don't buy it. You know, with the network failing, the stock going down. So, and then again, the ratings are just going down. He says the ratings in the short term, you know, because of Monday Night Football, they're going down, which may well be true, but in the long run, they're just going down. Like, when's the last time you had a Raw above a 3 rating? I mean, that's fucking ridiculous for a Monday Night Raw. I mean, the ratings are now below 3s consistently, pretty much. I mean, it's fucking just a shame. So then he says, yeah, the company's not losing money and ratings go down during Monday Night Football. Austin and Rock were on every week, too. I don't get what he says. Austin and Rock are on every week, too. I didn't get what he said by that. And then,
this guy says, this random guy says, as far as I know, they're actually making more money now than they did back then. Then Road Dogg responds to this guy, you are correct, sir, a lot more. It's easier to hate and be negative to some. You know, it's not easy to be negative. It's just my opinion, Road Dogg. You know, it's easy to go up there and suck WWE's cock and say the Usos and Sheamus are good when they're, you know, when I don't see anybody really liking them. So, yeah, they're really making a lot of money right now. Yeah, Vince McMahon is really making a lot of money right now. Yeah, he fucking had, like, $1 billion. Now he's down to, like, what, $666 million? Something shit like that. Yeah, they're not firing anybody because of money problems right now. No, they're not. You know, they haven't gotten rid of various employees because of money problems. No, they haven't. You know, just denying reality, pretty much. And then they say, known as the IWC, they know it all. All kidding aside, this is a random guy saying this. All kidding aside, they are also fans who actually appreciate your hard work. Thanks for that. I don't say I know it all. How many times do I say in my videos, comment on my videos because I want to know more information about the topic. I want to learn more opinions. I don't say I know. I'm just telling my opinion. And to me, my opinion is 100% fact. To me, not to everybody. But I don't lie about my opinion. And I always say in my videos, comment so I could learn more viewpoints and learn more information on the topic. I always say that. I say that a lot. So I don't know it all. A lot of people who are experts on certain issues know a lot more than I do. But, you know, if you go by, like, real issues, like politic issues and the world issues, I know more than the average person my age, and I certainly know more than an average 40-year-old, I think. I don't know for sure about real issues like U.S. funds ISIS, you know, just the U.S. is letting a bull in. I know more about that than I think the average person. So then, he doesn't respond to me, I don't think. I think he he said, like, don't bother responding or something like that, too. For some reason, it's not in here, I don't think. I don't see it specifically. Let me see if I can find it here. Sorry for the... Oh, here we go. Let me see where you put it here. He's like, I don't see it. He was like, yeah, I looked through your profile, don't bother responding. He said that too. I don't see that tweet in here for some reason though. But it's like, yeah, I looked through your profile, like saying that I had a bad profile when all I do is tweet my opinion. I don't troll. Maybe sometimes I get carried away on my YouTube videos and insult people for, you know, liking somebody. But I don't know if I've ever done that. Maybe as a group, but I've never singled out anybody individually for their opinions on a wrestler. You know, I contradict their opinions, but I don't say, oh, you're a fucking bitch for liking Randy Orton. I just say he does rest holds all day and does fucking boring-ass moves that I can do, like right here. He just steps on somebody's toe. Do you really think that's entertaining? That's what I say. I'm like, are you blind? Do you think that's entertaining? Do you really, okay, you know, if you think stepping on somebody's toe like that is entertaining, then whatever, you know, I just don't get it. But anyway, you know, Road Dogg, you know, I tweet out my opinion, not trying to troll. I'm not a troller, whatever the troller is that what they're referred to? I don't troll people on here. I don't go on famous people's accounts and write fucking dirty messages to get people to look at my account. I don't troll. I don't bother other people like that. And people who are subscribed to my channel know I don't. I'm a real person. And you know what it feels like to be a real person? It feels damn good to be a real person. Because you know, some person might have some more views than me, you know, being a troll. But their morality is very well hurt. And I cannot live with myself if I, you know, got undeserved views and undeserved attention by trolling. I want to get views and likes and comments, whatever, subscribers, by being a real person, putting out real videos and being real. And that's what I was doing to Road Dogg, just tweeting my opinion, you know, saying the company is shit. He just pretty much disrespects me. And instead of saying, you know, how can we, maybe he should have said, how can we improve in the company? What do you think we should do? You know, and I would have tweeted nicely back and said something like that. You know, put Raw in 2 hours, blah, 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 blah. I've said a lot of suggestions on my channel to improve the show, but yeah, Road Dogg pretty much just, you know, disrespects me as a fan, just tweeting my opinions of the product. So there you go, people.